The soul of the Vikings lay in the longship. They had a bold, and now in the 8th and 9th centuries carried to perfection a vessel which by its shallow draft could sail far up rivers or anchor in innumerable creeks and bays, and which by its beautiful lines and suppleness of construction could ride out the fiercest storms of the Atlantic Ocean. We are singularly well informed of these ships. Half a dozen have been dug up almost intact. The most famous were unearthed at Gokstad in Norway and in 1880 from a tumulus. It is almost complete, even to cooking pots and draft boards for the sailors. It is remeasured with precision in 1944 in spite of other distractions. This ship was of medium size, 76 feet 6 inches from stem to stern, 70 feet 6 inches beam and drawing only 2 feet 9 inches amidships. She was clinker built of 16 strakes of a side of solid oak planks, fastened with 3 nails and iron bolts and caulked with cord of plaited animal hair. Her planks fastened to the ribs with bar ties gave the framework greater elasticity. She had a deck of loose unnailed boards, but no doubt her stores were contained in lockers which were buried. The masts were stepped in a huge solid block which, says Professor Collingwood, whose description I have revised today, was so uncunningly transported that while the mast stands steady and firm, there is no strain on the light elastic frame of the ship. She has 16 oars aside, varying in length between 17 and 19 feet. The longer oars were used at the prow and stern. When a gunwale was higher above the waterline, they were all beautifully shaped and passed through circular rodocks cut in the main strake, which were neatly fitted with shutters that closed when the oars were shipped. A rudder stepped to the starboard quarter was a large, short oar of cricket bat shape, fitted with a movable tiller and fastened to the ship by an ingenious contrivance which gave the blade full play. The mast, 40 feet high, had a long, heavy yard with a square sail. She could carry a small boat or dinghy, three of which were discovered with her. The Gokstad ship could carry a crew of 50 and, if necessary, another 30 warriors or captives in all weathers for a month. Such was the vessel which, in many different sizes, bore the Vikings to the plunder of the civilized world, to the assault of Constantinople, to the siege of Paris, to the foundation of Dublin, and the discovery of America. Its picture rises before us vivid and bright. The finely carved, dragon-shaped prow, the high curving stern, the low row of shields, black and yellow alternately ranged along the sides, the gleam of steel, the scent of murder. The long ships in which the great ocean voyages were made of somewhat stouter build with a higher freeboard, but the Gokstad model was reproduced in 1892 and navigated by a Norwegian crew across the Atlantic in 4 weeks. Yet this superb instrument of sea power would have been useless without the men who handled it. All were volunteers. Party were formed under leaders of marked ability. In the sagas we read of crews of champions or merry men, a ship's company picked out no doubt with many applicants as good at the helm or oar as they were with the sword.